A very good morning to all. Myself, Dr. Abarna Thangappan. Today, we will discuss about C++ fundamentals. Like all programming languages, C++ has its own vocabulary and grammar. In this section, we shall discuss about this C++ grammar consisting of character set, variables, constants, data types, operators, and expressions. First of all, we will discuss the character set. The characters are used to form words, numbers, and expressions in any programming language. First one is letters. It consists of uppercase letters, capital A to Z, and lowercase letters, small letter A to Z. And it shall also be noted that the upper and lowercase letters are not interchangeable. Like C, C++ is also strongly case sensitive. And next is digits. It consists of numbers from 0 to 9. And special characters. Some of the special characters as below, comma, ampersand, semicolon, carriage, colon, asterisk, question mark, plus sign, single quotation, minus sign, double quotation, less than sign. Again, exclamation, greater than sign, vertical bar, left and right parentheses, slash, left and right brackets, backslash, left and right braces, tilde, hash, underscore, dollar sign, percentage sign. And about white spaces, that consist of blank space, new line, form field, carriage return, and horizontal tab. And about C++ token. There are 5 kinds of token in C++. They are identifier, keywords, literals, operators, and white space. C++ identifiers. The identifier may be the name of a variable or constant or a function. Usually, for all programming languages, the first character of the identifier will be an alphabet, followed either by number or alphabet. Unlike C, C++ does not impose any restriction on identifier length. And also note that all C++ compilers are case sensitive. Usually underscore are allowed for better readability, but no special characters are allowed while defining an identifier. Anyway, underscore are allowed for better readability. This is an example. That is the volume, that is the correct identifier, and one area, that is incorrect because it starts with a numeric, and area underscore plus, that is also correct. Underscore is a special character, but it is allowed for better readability. And area plus, though it is allowed, it is not encouraged to us, area plus. Okay. And keywords. Keywords are words that have specific purpose in C++ language. So, we cannot use them as our variable name or function name. There are 63 keywords in C++. And some of the keywords are ASM auto, break, case, cache, character, float, friend. Among this character, break, float, friend, false, if, they are switch, they are the important one. And again class, that is also important. And double, return, public, private, protected. these are void. These are the important keywords that we have used, regularly used. And about constants, the value of a quantity that does not vary throughout the program, that is called constant, that we know. C++ support several types of constants. Like C, C++ also support string constants, that is enclosed between double quotes, that is string constant. Here that is an example, welcome to C++, that is enclosed within the double quote, that is the string constant. And a single character, that is enclosed between single quotes, that is B, that is within single quotes, that is a single character. And the group of the single character, that is the string, that is string constant, that is enclosed within the double quotes. And next is data type. The basic data types in C++ are integer, float, character, and void. Void means valueless. And type modifiers. Some of the modifiers are signed, unsigned, long, short. And integer. These are numbers without decimal part. That is numbers without decimal part, which may or may not be prefixed with the minus sign. That is minus sign, that is doesn't matter, but it has not the decimal part. Some of the integer range, short integer range, long integer range, and that is short integer range is -327682 +327667, occupies 2 bytes. And long integer range, it has a lengthy number, actually it occupies 8 bytes. And in integer range, it represents large integer values, requires twice the amount of the short, and it ranges from this one to this one, and it occupies 4 bytes. And next is about variable. Variable, we can say it is a storehouse for constants. And not that, the declaration of a variable, that is the general form of variable declaration, is data type and variable list. And noted that the declaration statement must end with a semicolon. That is noted, must end with a semicolon. The examples are short area, inch volume, long circumference. All are end with the semicolon. And next is float. They are the numbers with decimal part, that is not that should be noted, the numbers with the decimal part, and number without decimal part is the integer section. Numbers with the decimal part is the float section. That is float. The sum of the modifiers in this range, that is float, double, long, double. Float stores up to 7 decimal place. Double 15 decimal place, long double 19 decimal place. And about the character, any single letter enclosed within the single quote is identified as character. That we already discussed, that is string and string character constant. And a single character constant. String character constant, that is enclosed within single quote, and string constant, that is the group of the characters, we call it as string, that is enclosed within the double quotes. Okay, thank you.